86% of women say they want a man to make the first move. A different study said that 50% of men say that they're afraid of making the first move for being seen as creepy. Another study said that 20% of Gen Zers say that a man approaching a woman sometimes or always constitutes harassment. So you have a world in which women are scared of being approached, men are scared of doing the approaching, people will judge many men, at least one in five men that do that, as being harassers, but everybody understands that if the guys don't make the first move, nothing's going to happen. If guys do make the first move, they're scared of being me too'd. Girls are scared of being approached by guys that they don't know, but also still know that they need the guys to make the first move 86% of the time, because that's the percentage. Isn't that fucking interesting?
So I could hit you up and say, hey, let's go to Burger King and get slushies?
No. At least, like, you know, nice five-star type of restaurant, and then depending on how it goes, depending how I like you, and that all kind of goes with me even saying yes for a first actual date.
So a five-star restaurant in Miami, how much is that going to range?
Depends how many drinks you'll be ordering.
Average.
Anywhere from 300 to 800, maybe.
Realistically, you expect a man to spend $800 on a first day?
Yeah.
What modern women expect of men today, what they expect of you as a man to do for them on dates. Now, it's not all women, but this is something that we're starting to see as a pattern. To be forking over hundreds of dollars for a woman who could potentially be using them for a foodie date or who really isn't interested at all. In today's episode, there's a black woman who is on the internet talking about how regular men need to shut up, that regular men are talking like they have way more, but because they're not millionaires and because they're not rich, then they need to stop acting like they have a bunch of options. Do me a favor, hit that like button. With that being said, let's get started.
Goodness freaking gracious, I don't know what I have to tell males, the average American male, to get them to understand that you're not a millionaire, you're not above average, and it's okay to be average, but stop pretending like you're above average and that a woman would marry you just to divorce you to get your little bit of money.
Men need to stop pretending like women are divorcing them to get money. It don't matter if the man is rich or a regular dude. If all these women supposedly didn't care about it, then why don't you hear of any instances, very few instances, where women go through divorce court and ask for nothing? They never not ask for anything, even if the man isn't rich. And I'm gonna show you some clips on that after we continue watching this.
You work at Walmart. You work in a distribution center. You work in the warehouse. You wear those fluorescent vests. You have no property in your name. You don't own a home. You don't have any real estate in your name. Your grandfather did not pass down an inheritance to you.
And most black women don't have an inheritance passed down to them either. What is she talking about? You know what I mean? Like, what is she really saying? A lot of us have been put in that position where we haven't had anything passed down to us. And the amount of entitlement for her to go ahead and assume that just because a man looks a certain way, that he doesn't have property or he doesn't own stuff or he doesn't have assets. But everything with these modern women are about being flashy and about showing off. But let's finish to continue what she has to say.
I really be confused on what y'all think women are gonna get from y'all by divorcing y'all. You're not a millionaire. You probably won't ever be. And that's okay. But stop being delusional by thinking that women will divorce you just for they'll marry you to divorce you for your money. That pocket change? Come on.
I love when these modern women get on here and they will always tell you a partial truth and then they'll give you the lie. And in this, she tried to basically say that she's not dissing regular men, that nothing's wrong with being average, while making a diss video doing it.
Gotcha, bitch.
See what I'm saying? The truth and then the lie is, again, with this narrative that she's trying to say that women ain't trying to divorce dudes for money who ain't got money, who aren't divorcing regular dudes and causing them to ruin their life. Women will take any advantage that they can get from you as a man. You don't hear these women saying, don't worry about it, I got it. Don't worry about it, I'm not going to take your house from you. Don't worry about it, we don't need to divide none of these assets. You know what? I'll start all over again. And I can tell you guys from firsthand experiences from my divorces that even though I paid for everything in the house, I left with half or less than half. I got stuck with all the debt. I got stuck with paying out the child support. I got stuck with making sure that they were taken care of. Even the ex was taken care of while I went homeless. So it doesn't matter if you're rich or not. I was making six figures and this happened to me. I want you to watch the next couple of videos and I want you to see that you have a bunch of men who are just regular guys who get married or get with these women, and these women will not tell the truth. They will take and extract as many resources as necessary so that they okay. And they'll even lie to do it.
What you mean is not my child?
This is not your child.
What you mean?
This is not your child. I'm just letting you know so you won't, you know, this is not your child.
So I've been paying child support on this man for five years, and he tells me it's not my child?
Yeah, this is not your child, but I thank you for everything you're doing, but you know.
Oh, babe, we ain't going down like that.
Why is not? You about to go. I'm about to take you. Man, look, bro. You about to just go.
I've been paying $700 a month for 4 years, bruh. You know how much that is?
But I'm just
That's like $8,400 a year. 4 years.
I'm letting you know so you won't get a DNA test that he's not your child.
Man, that's like $37,000. But you got the $30,000 to give me back, or it's going to be an issue.
Well, we can work something out. Can we just work something out?
I mean, what you trying to work out, bro? Because that's $37,000.
I don't know, a plan or something. If you want to take me to court, feel me? I don't know, but I'm just letting you know. Something about DNA test.
Yeah, something's going to happen because I ain't playing about no 30 racks. I ain't going to lie. I don't care if a child or not. I love him. But you telling me that ain't mine, so I don't care about none of that.
Alright, we about to go then.
Man, yeah, but hey, look, figure out how you gonna get my money.
Alright.
Sure, you figure out how you gonna get my bread, though.
You spent 5 years in prison for failing to pay child support for the defendant, Ms. Sears' son, Dylan.
That's right.
Mr. Manser, you are not.
Oh, God.
His father.
5 years in prison.
You know who his father is.
Yes, I talk to him still.
She should be convicted of some crime.
No, I should not. I didn't.
That is fraud.
That shit bothers me, man. Dude, there is an epidemic of gold digging whores in this country. And every night I put on the news and I'm waiting for someone to address it. Every night, never see it, you know? I'm talking about whores, people.
He cleaned the house. He took the kids to school. He worked all day. He made good money. He supported us. He was the good guy. So I'm here to tell you, it's okay to leave the good guy.
Somebody, go ahead. Somebody, explain. Justify it.